Today I'm going to be giving you a brief introduction to the endocrine system. The endocrine system is your system of the body that deals with hormones. Now, you might be thinking, hormones, aren't we done with those? Didn't we deal with those during puberty? Well, yes, of course you dealt with them in puberty, but the reality is that hormones affect us every day. Now, of course, just like puberty, there are some other times in your life where you have major hormonal shifts. For a woman, that might include pregnancy, and for all of us, that includes aging. But there are lots of ways in which hormones impact us every minute of every day, whether it's when we wake up or perhaps sometime during the day when we're feeling a little bit tired, or even the sensation of being hungry. Those are all things that are controlled by hormones. Hormones are not just things that are a boring element of every day. They're actually really fascinating, and you'll learn about several of them in class. One thing about hormones that's neat is that there's lots of active research happening about them, and we're discovering lots of neat things. So for example, oxytocin is a hormone that we know is a part of labor. It causes uterine contractions in women when they're having a baby. It also is crucial for that bonding of mother and infant. And even in intimate relationships that you have romantically, there's a sense of bonding that's linked to the release of this hormone, oxytocin. There's also things like growth hormone that we hear about in the news. Some of that we hear about because there are athletes who are doping. They're basically using human growth hormone to help them get stronger and faster in their competitions. That's illegal, of course, but it's something we've heard about Olympians and professional athletes who have had medals or trophies taken away because of this kind of use. So hormones are a part of everyday life, but they're also a part of breaking news. So what exactly are hormones? Hormones are secreted biomolecules. Hormones are active at a cell and tissue that's distinct from where they were made. So hormones are made in one place and usually have their impact somewhere else in the body. Hormones bind to receptors that are either on the surface or inside that target cell. So we can find hormone receptors, again, on the plasma membrane or surface of a cell or in the cytoplasm of a cell. Hormones get from the place they're made to those target cells and tissues through the bloodstream. There are two different kinds of hormones, and we'll talk more about these in class. There are peptide hormones and steroid hormones. Steroid hormones you can see in the top part of this figure. Here's some green hormone, and those hormones are actually going right through the plasma membrane into the cell, where they'll bind to a receptor that's in the cytoplasm. That combination of hormone and receptor, you can see, can go to the nucleus and cause differences in what genes are expressed. So they'll cause an effect in that target cell. Peptide hormones act similarly. Here you can see a different kind of hormone, but this time the receptor for that hormone is on the surface of the cell. That hormone is going to bind to the cell surface receptor. So here you see that cell surface receptor. And that stays here at the surface, but it causes some intracellular changes that again lead to that cell making different kinds of proteins. Different genes get expressed. So in both of these cases, both steroid hormones and peptide hormones, they're interacting with the target cell and causing some kind of effect. They might tell that cell to do something differently, to make something differently, to move somewhere, to make some kind of communication molecule, who knows. Okay, so where do hormones come from? I told you that they're made in a place that's distinct from where they have action. So there are special endocrine glands. Other tissues also make hormones. And again, we'll talk more about these in class, but I wanted to give you a preview of some of the other places besides the specialized glands where we make some hormones. Here you can see the heart and the stomach, the brain, your adrenal glands are near your kidneys. Here's the liver, and here's some fat tissue, which I know isn't very attractive, but this is adipose tissue, and we're able to secrete some hormones right out of that fat tissue. So how does your body know when to make these specific hormones? Usually there's some kind of a trigger, and most of these hormones operate through what we call a negative feedback loop. The negative feedback loop is shown here to the right. So we have some trigger, some issue that occurs, you know, so that triggers, and then the hormones are made and released. And usually those hormones then cause that issue to go away, they're resolved. And that's where this ends. So once the hormone is released, it actually causes that trigger to go away and the process stops. So that's a negative feedback loop. An example of what that would look like in real life is that your body temperature would rise, you sweat, and then your body temperature drops because the moisture helps you cool. So that's a real example of a negative feedback loop where you have a trigger, hormones are released and some kind of action takes place, and then that trigger is now disappeared. Your body's at a normal temperature. Let's do a little bit of a review. Which of the following is not true? Now review the answers and then hit pause while you make your decision. Okay, did you pause it? Because I'm going to give you the answer. The answer is A. Hormones are created at the site where they are needed. That's not true. Remember, hormones are almost always created at a site distinct from where they're needed. So here's a critical thinking exercise we'd like you to do before class. Think about what would happen if, instead of working with a negative feedback loop, hormones instead worked with a positive feedback loop, where the more impact they had, the more hormone would be produced. An example of a positive feedback loop is given below, where as your account balance grows, you earn more interest, and as you earn more interest, your account balance grows, and that cycle repeats. So think about that positive feedback loop, and if hormones acted on that way instead of with a negative feedback loop, what impact would that have? Okay, thank you again for listening, and we'll see you in class.